Okay. Good morning, students. Have a wonderful day. Now see, before of that, I have sent to the PDF which contains the formulas. Okay. It means formula regarding to CP. What is CP? That is cost price. What is SP? That is selling price. Again, we have seen when we get the profit and when we get the loss. Along with this one, we have also seen that what is the profit percentage as well as loss percentage. Okay. Within that, we have seen the topic of simple interest. That is, we have seen principal, P for the principal. Okay. Again, we have seen I or SI. That is, we call interest on the particular principal. Means principal is what? It is a borrowed money. Okay. For a particular time duration, no, we just borrow some money from the bank in order to buy something new. Okay. If you don't have a money, then what we do? We just borrow the money from someone else or from the bank. Okay. But after some type of duration, like after the 1 year or 2 years, like as that, we have to pay that borrowed money to that particular person or to that particular bank. Okay. But we will not return it, whatever the amount that we have borrowed. Along with this one, we have to pay some extra money. Okay. So that is called as a interest. Okay. That is called as an interest, or we can call it as a simple interest. Again, principal, I and rate is that of which rate you just borrowed that money. That is called as a rate of the interest. Okay. Again, there is a T. T it means what? It is called as a time duration. Means for 1 year you are taking that, or for 2 year you are taking that, or for 3 year like as that, or only 5 months. Generally we take the money for the 1 year. Okay. In a bank also, if you take the loan, it will have the time. It will have the time duration of 1 year minimum. Okay. Then rather than this one, you can make it for 2 year, 3 year, as per your convenience. Okay. So like as that, we have seen these four concepts. Same we have to use along in this exercise 8.3 in the word problems. Okay. So we will see it one by one. Now before of that, what we have to do? Before of that, we have to learn that formulas or the word problems which is regarding to the profit and loss. Okay. So already I have told you in the live classes that when we get the profit and when we get the loss. Actually, here I have written that question in the short. You just look into the book. Okay. So your question is like, till profit or loss, whether it is done in the profit in that question or loss. Whether in that question also, whether you find that here you got the profit or loss. And along with this one, if you get the profit, they are asking you to find out its percentage. If you are getting the loss, then also they are asking you to find out the percentage of that loss. Okay. We call it as a loss percentage. Similarly, it will be held here. Okay. So just go through it. We will take the solution. Like, gardening shirts brought for rupees 250 and sold it for rupees 325. Okay. So now look at here. You have to find out the two costs here. One is what? CP. Okay. One is what we call CP. CP means cost price. Means, suppose this duster is there. For what rupees I have taken it from the wholesale dealer or from the shopkeeper, it is called cost price. And now if I don't want this duster, I'm just trying to selling it or give it to another person. So that will be my selling price. Okay. Whatever the price that I have taken it, I have brought it, it is called as a cost price. So brought it means, brought how much for how much rupees? 250. So brought it means cost price. So cost price will be rupees how much? 250. Again, sold. Sold it means selling price. Okay. So your selling price will be SP is equal to how much? Rupees 325. Now, within that, you have to first of all find out whether you are in the profit situation or whether you are in the loss situation. Now, tell me, you have taken that particular thing on a 250 rupees. Okay. But you have sold it for how many rupees? 325. It means you have taken for a less amount, but you are selling for the more amount. It means you are in the profit situation. You are in the profit situation. Okay. Because your cost price is smaller than the selling price. It means your selling price is greater than the cost price. Okay. So that's why your condition is SP is greater than CP. So you are in the profit situation. Which situation? Profit situation. Okay. So if profit is done, you have to find out how much profit you are done with this one. How much profit you have done? What is the formula of profit? Profit is equal to SP minus CP. So what is your SP here? That is 325. minus 250, how much? 5. Again 2 minus 5, is it possible?
No.
So take it here 2 and it will become